For 22 years, racing fans get the opportunity to witness what is considered by many the biggest sport compact event of the year, held in Atco Dragway, New Jersey. Cars from all over the U.S. come by the hundreds for a chance to qualify and represent Team USA against their brothers in battle from across the ocean, Team Puerto Rico. For them, the ticket to the U.S. began months ago in a brutal racing season in which each driver earns points throughout a series of events. Money or industry politics cannot buy you a pass, they earn it. Their journey begins thousands of miles away in an island they know as Borinquen.
Por siempre la llamaré preciosa. Yo sé de sus hembras trigueñas, sé del olor de sus rosas. Por eso a mi tierra riqueña, por siempre la llamaré preciosa.
Puerto Rico is known for building some of the fastest imports in the world and having a good time while doing it. Team Puerto Rico arrives well represented, and among the racing figures are also the racing personalities that are religiously following social media.
Un año más, Juanchi, el MMB aquí en New Jersey. Un año más para que no nos cuenten, ya tú sabes, estamos aquí ready. Y si los que siempre llegan tarde, ¿quién va a ser? Los de la tsunami. Allí dejaron la tuvimos que mira Freddy, Luis y yo, Juanchi, MMB, ponerle en la carpa y todavía no han llegado esos mamabichos. Víctor, eres un mamabicho.
Fifteen out of the 16 cars from Puerto Rico are injected and controlled by the Australian-made engine management system, Microtech EFI. After winning the event last year, Team MF Import have made several changes to the car, including fitting a new Microtech LT32 Big Bertha ECU. Also among them is the highly anticipated return of the Pika Motors RX-7, driven by Oso. Team Puerto Rico does not have to qualify for the 16 spots. Their ticket here earns them a guaranteed spot. Their qualification runs are given to adjust to track conditions and dial in their times. The Pan Americans or Atco are bracket races. Friday evening brings the cars to the track for the first time. Not only is this session used as a shakedown pass for teams to adjust their cars to the track and weather conditions, it is also the first round of qualifying. For Team USA, only their quickest 16 cars qualify for the honor to represent their country and line up against Team Puerto Rico on Sunday. With so many cars fighting to make the top 16, drivers and tuners need to push things to the limit to make it into the field. Among them are many previous event winners, as well as some of the most consistent drivers in the lineup. To make things even more complicated, the US side is full of 6-second cars, making the bracket dials even tougher. Some of these cars arrive quietly, but others have won recent events. The US side also favors Microtech EFI. The majority of cars running on both sides are being controlled by a common denominator. The effect of the bracket racing rules is to place a premium on consistency of performance of the driver and car rather than raw speed. Dialing in, reaction time, and braking out are all parameters by which races are won or lost. This format allows for a wide variety of cars racing against each other, slower cars racing faster cars, compensated by an earlier light, while fast cars wait, often fouling on the reaction time. Black Diamond is another 6-second 2JZ, this one driven by Josian Colon from Bayamon, Puerto Rico. A 7-second pass shows it could be challenging to dial in the car, as he has multiple passes in the sixes. Making his return to the track after taking out the imports versus domestic event in Maryland last November, and former Rotary World Record holder, is the Joyan RX-8 with Jose Siguel Torres behind the wheel. Siguel, the first man ever to pilot a rotary power car into the 6-second zone. First pass, the car runs a very impressive 6.5 second pass off the trailer. The car everyone expects to be top qualifier, El Jerry, after running several passes in the 6-0s and being the car most likely to be the next to break into the 5-second zone, the pressure is on the team to perform to the high expectations, with Puerto Rico's most experienced driver behind the wheel, Jorge Lascano. The car performed perfectly and, as expected, went straight into the number one qualifying position with a 6.2 second pass. El Profesor from Tampa, Florida, driven by another rotary mastermind, Edwin Loquito Killer, is expected to run in the low sevens consistently, and it delivers. Hey. first chance to acquire data is reached, and already engines are being pulled out, some for inspection and others for replacement. Saturday afternoon brings the cars to the line for the second round of qualifying, with ambient temperatures hovering around the 100 degree mark and track temperatures soaring much higher. Tuners have their work cut out for them, getting the cars down the hot track in the sweltering conditions. While most cars struggle to get down the track in the heat, other cars like the 13B Power RX-8, real gangster for life, make it look easy. Another new car with only one test session before this event and already is running in the 6-second zone, putting the car in a high qualifying position for Sunday. The cars with 6-second passes in their inventory are delivering 6-second times in Atco. But a 7-second car has just as much of a chance to win in this event. And no one knows that more than Willie Lopez. Running a kilo engine that has been in the car now for over 2 seasons, he doesn't bother checking the data between rounds. He simply tops up the fuel, packs the chutes, and heads to the staging lanes, ready for the next pass. Cars that have ran 6.9s are finding a place in the low 7s. Others push things to the limits, trying to make the cut, sometimes with disastrous results. Even stock chassis cars in the mids to high 7s have a chance. Old-school rotary followers are stoked to see the former rotary world record holder Sammy Promotions back in action with his unique 3-rotor, 3-turbo combination. Last year's winner has not been able to put a solid pass so far, and qualifiers are running out. The last day of qualifiers is on countdown, and engines continue to be swapped in the pits.
Este es el motor viejo. Este es el nuevo.
All the teams work hard preparing their cars for the final round of qualifying scheduled for Saturday night. A huge thunderstorm is building in the horizon. Shortly after, the heavens open, unleashing a torrential downpour that lasts for several hours. It continues to pour in Atco, and no signs of the rain stopping. Flood warnings for the New Jersey area are released, and the event is eventually canceled for the rest of Saturday. A lot of rain has fallen overnight, but the sun quickly makes an appearance. Spirits are high for both the racers and the crowd, with this being the last day for the event. They'll have to get it all in, racing and partying.
¿Dónde están los de la isla? Escúchenme, si hacen un coro conmigo. Si no es roto y no tiene botón. Si no es roto y no tiene botón.
Teams missing the third and final qualifier on Saturday night due to the rain, the final qualifier has been moved to Sunday morning, giving those teams who haven't cemented their way in the field one last chance to make their way in. With all the big name cars making the 32 car field, the crowd is expecting to see some quick ETs, close racing, and as history proves every year in the Pan Americans, some big upsets. The Atco crowd loves nothing more than to see a low budget underdog car eliminate a big money car and put it on the trailer early, and 2016 is no different, with several of the faster cars exiting in the first round. Pika Motors, the crowd's favorite, is having problems. After all the rain overnight, some of the extension cords providing power to the battery chargers work inconsistently. The RX-7 is having problems with the battery, and the car won't start, an unfortunate way to be eliminated. Another crowd favorite, Joyan Racing RXA smokes the tires off the line and is also eliminated in the first round. Already, a handful of 6-second cars are eliminated in the earlier rounds, proving that bracket racing is open game. Sammy Promotions goes down the track leaving a cloud of smoke and is able to pull a win. The RX-7 is hurt and dodges a bullet. El Brujo on the right lane has won this event in the past, but this year he's eliminated early. MF Import encounters damages to the wheelie bar ball joints and works fast to address the problem. With Saturday's cancellations, every team is working harder due to the constrained timeline today. Willy Lopez continues to put down passes consistently in the 7-3s. The car seems to be dialed perfectly. If the Willy bar in the MF Import Scion fails, the event could have a new winner this year, but the team succeeds. A few cars from Team USA are eliminated, and there is a feeling that Team Puerto Rico could repeat with a winner, but quietly the Black Diamond continues to press for Team USA. Left lane faults on the light, automatic win for Black Diamond. El Jerry, driven by Lascano, powerful 2JZ, chases down the track with the late light and succeeds. After damaging a turbocharger in the previous round and such a short turnaround between rounds, Sammy Promotions comes to the line with a broken turbo and down on power. They are unable to build boost on the line and their day is now over. El Nachi from Puerto Rico has made it far and now faces Willy Lopez. El Choki, driven by Florito, faces Black Diamond and Josian. El Jerry continues to bracket well despite its powerful setup and greater possibilities for tire shake and things to go wrong. Of the four cars going to the semifinals, three are from USA and one from Puerto Rico. All four cars are Microtech. One of the hardest aspects of bracket racing is for the faster car, seeing his rival launch while anxiously waiting for their light and a good reaction to catch up, often fouling at the light. This is an automatic win for Willy Lopez on the left lane.
Vamos,
defending champion is still alive and must eliminate Black Diamond on the right lane. Both cars are 6-second cars and have experienced drivers. This year, the Pan Americans will have a new champion. Black Diamond eliminates last year's winner, the MF Motor Import Scion. The finals is a quick turnaround. Just enough time to check the engine bay and give the battery a quick charge.
Contrincante fácil, pero vamos a ver qué pasa. Estamos ready para la final.
After 12 months of hard work for both teams, it is time for the final round. One car will walk away with the prize money, a win for their country, and bragging rights for the next year. The stage is set for a classic piston versus rotor, 13B versus 2JZ battle. After performing flawlessly all weekend, the Lopez Racing Datsun breaks fifth gear in the transmission, making it an easy task for the 2JC Power Black Diamond Scion to take the win for Team USA and be crowned the 2016 Pan Americans champion.
Casi no tengo palabras. Gracias a Dios, Guillo, los muchachos. No puedo pedir mucho. La primera vez que me montan el carro. Y ya viste los resultados. Gracias a Dios, se comportó el carro perfecto. Yo hice mi trabajo y logramos salir por la puerta ancha, gracias a Dios.
Nos volvimos a abrazar, el río retornó al mar. Yo oyó el canteo de un gallo y yo yendo mi caballo lo volví a desencillar. Y yo yendo mi caballo lo volví a desencillar, ensillando mi caballo.